caught in the crossfire. It's caught in the crossfire. Good morning, everybody. Today is Wednesday, the 3rd of April, and it's 10 o'clock in the morning. As you can see, I just woke up several hours ago. Just played. Yesterday I went ahead and cut up some boards, 2x4s, yesterday to finish up the stand. In my last couple of videos, I did say that the inside of the tank is completely done. All I got to do is just order my paint and get it sealed up, put the glass in, good to go. This is the glass that I'm going to be using. It is 6 foot long by a half inch thick and 2 feet wide. That's what's going right here as a viewing point. And one, of course, going straight up and down right here where the glass is actually sitting at. These are the boards that I cut up yesterday. This is a foot and a half. This will be going down beneath the tank. I will show you guys why that is. Same with these boards. These are 3 foot. These ones are 3 foot. These will be as bracing for underneath as well. I will show you on where these are going. This right here is 61 inches long. This one and this one will be going underneath as well. And I will also show you why. This is 28 inches by 7/8, and I will show you what these are for, and I got 3 of them cut the exact same size, and I will tell you why they have to be the exact same size. This board is 39 inches long, and I will show you where this is going. On the top of the tank. I also have more of these thinner boards to put, as you can see, doesn't have it here. You gotta put one here and one at the back of it. So now I'm going to explain to you guys on what those boards are for. And then I'm also going to show you guys what kind of new subsystem I am going to use. Because like I said in my other videos, I am not doing a sub tank. I will not be building one. I wanted to, but my wife and I are looking at land for next year, and hopefully by then we'll be able to put something on there and blah blah blah, so we would have to move, and it will be a hassle already to deal with the big tank on taking it down. Don't get me wrong. It is easy to take down. I made sure the way I designed this tank to break down just by undoing certain bolts or screws, and it will just come down. So that's a good thing. But as for the sub tank, it's not going to work because the sub tank will actually have to be built in with the stand, and I don't want to do all that because that will take forever to take apart. So I am just going to use tanks, and I will show you how I'm going to do that today. So let's go ahead and do this, shall we? So this is what I'm going to be doing for underneath the tank. If my camera will stop being so goddamn blurry. There we go. So this tank, I am not for sure what the size is. I believe it's a 30 gallon. That's a 55 gallon. That's a 40 gallon. Right here is gonna be another 55 in this opening. And I have to get these out because I have to take the floor up for the 3 foot boards that I showed you. That are gonna go this way for extra support. Because as you can see, I never finished it from the last video. But that side is all done. As you can see the screws, there's already beams going that way. This one doesn't have any. As you can see, there are no holes for screws, no nothing. So I gotta put beams going this way. So, I am using tanks, just like over there. Sorry for the mess, but do you see how I have my tanks linking from one to another, and then the pump pumping the water going into the 75 gallon and then dumping back in to the 255s and doing it again and again and again. And when the power shuts off, it does not overflow. It doesn't. It can't. There's no way. I will explain that to you here later. So that's what I'm going to do for underneath here. Those boards that I cut is going to raise each tank up by maybe an inch, some of them maybe by 2 inches, and I will show you how, and I will also show you how I am going to run this system for now. So let's go ahead and start pulling all those out and getting the floorboard done. So let's go ahead and do that. So as you can see, there's where the 3 foot long beams had to go, right on underneath the floor. So that's all done. I can go ahead and put my floor back together, and then the next step is showing you guys what the other 2x4s are used for. So let's go ahead and do that.
Thank you.
Ta-da! Okay, got the floor done. That's all done. I'm not worried about that little strip missing back there. Not worried about that. I'll do that later. So I got that main part down. Now, it's time for these boards. And I'm gonna explain how these boards are going to work for what I'm going to be doing. Now, these boards, I believe, are 61 inches long. So, put down my camera. And I'm going to measure this. This is 61 inches, both of them are. I kind of want them to be one right there and one about right here. This is where the 55 is going to sit on, and then the smaller tank is going to sit on half of this board, because the 55 is only 49 inches long. So the rest of it is going to be for the other tank to sit on at the end. So I'm going to go ahead and set my camera down and go ahead and start measuring out everything, and hopefully I get everything centered for the tank to sit on. So let's go ahead and do that, guys and girls. Okay, so I got the first couple of boards down. This one's 61 inches even. Those three little ones, or actually four, those four little ones are a foot and a half right on point. The only reason why is because when I set this tank on there, the tank is gonna go this way. Those are basically support beams to hold the tank. I'm just raising it up, just like the 55. And I realize that over here, I'm gonna have to do the same thing. Cut out some boards to raise up the smaller tank too. Because the small tank is pretty small, so it does need to be raised up. So I'm gonna have to cut out another three of the half inch or half foot ones. I have to cut three more of those. and cut some boards for this back tank. The 55 is going to sit on that right there. It's not going to go any higher than what it is. And also, I was measuring out everything here. Honestly, instead of using another 55 for this whole opening space, let's see how much space I got here. 19 inches. Okay, so I was just curious and seeing if my 75-gallon tank will be able to fit in that nice little gap. And let's check it out, shall we? You always want to measure these tanks from the plastic framing, not the glass itself, because there's about a quarter inch hanging off. So you always want to measure by the plastic, the trimming. So I have 18 and a half inches. So that means, ladies and gentlemen, I can actually take my 75-gallon tank and put it in that big open spot. Because if I'm correct, I believe, let's see, let's measure one of these 55s first. So 55 should be right at 4 feet, which is 48 inches. So that means this 75 should measure out about the same length. So I'm gonna have to put down the camera somewhere safe where it's not going to get injured. Injured. You know what? Hang on. I'll just pause it and put it somewhere safe. So the 75 will fit in that spot, which is awesome. So I'm gonna put my 75 in that big open spot instead of another 55. So what I've got going on will be a 40 gallon, a 55 gallon, a 30 gallon, and a 75 gallon. That means I will still have both my 55s open and I can use them still. But if I can get all this done, all of my fish and the tank, all the equipment will go underneath here for now. So that way I can have this open spot to dun dun dun, clean up all this goddamn mess. As I said, I did go through surgery, so you know, I was kind of in a hurry to get all this shit clean, but I didn't get that far. So enough of that shit. We're gonna go ahead and cut out the extra boards we need, and we'll go ahead and get going. So as you can see, I cut 3 more of the 1.5 foot long 2x4s to raise up that tank. This 55 is getting filled right now, as you can see. All I did is ran my PVC piping across from my pump so it can drain out those tanks. The 75 gallon is halfway drained and it will be put right here. And I went ahead and cut out boards for the smaller tank to raise up. As you can see, it drops. See how it drops down to the 55? And then the 75 will sit right here. So the 55 will drop down to the 75. And then the 75 will drop down to the 30. So it will just keep overflowing into one tank, into the other, and back into the other tank. That's what I'm going to be doing for right now until I can get the paint to paint this and set it all up. So that's pretty much what I'm doing for right now, guys. So I'll be back. I'm going to do all this off camera. And when I get back, we will talk about the bracing for the legs. As you can see, this is what I was talking about. See how it's just one leg and then you got the frame and then the other one on the bottom. Well, this board comes in handy. It sits right on that bottom frame and it gets tucked right up underneath the top frame and it has to be perfect. I cannot stress this out enough. A friend of mine tried doing this before and he ended up cutting too much and there was at least a half inch gap. And when he went to go set his tank on, about a year later, we noticed that the frame was actually coming off of the leg. The screws and the bolts were actually bending and actually looking for this board to sit on. So I cannot stress out enough, it has to be a good tight fit in there. So that way when the weight does add to the stand, it will sit on this board, sitting on the frame, on the concrete. That's how you support all the weight for your stands. Doubling up on the support helps a lot. And that's exactly how I'm doing that. I'm just doubling everything. Same over here too. Every leg has to have an extra support. Even behind here, as you can see. See the leg right there behind it? You take the other one and you place it right there, like a corner. You want to make a corner beam right here. If I can get this in there, but still, that's the way it should be. So, I'm going to do everything off camera, guys, and I will be back. Oh, one more thing. Say hello to our new family member, Shadow. Hi, buddy. My wife found out that she was allergic to kittens, so we had to get rid of both of our kittens, and we ended up getting this little guy. He's about 10 and a half weeks old, huh, buddy? Yeah. So every once in a while, guys, you'll see him in the video, huh, Shadow? All right, guys, I'll be back. So, I'm going to finish this stuff up tomorrow. It is getting pretty late, and it is 10 o'clock at night. It took me forever to drain out all the tanks and move them, and move this big tank, as you guys seen in the photos from earlier. I'm sorry I took photos in that video, because my camera said it was over. It didn't have enough memory, so I had to take care of that. But I will show you guys the rest of this tomorrow. As for now, peace. I'm going to bed.